वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज शुभद्रा सिंह फ्रॉम हाजी इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ फार्मास्यूटिकल एजुकेशन एंड रिसर्च एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट टॉपिक बेंजोडाइजेपिन्स। बेंजोडाइजेपिन्स आर द ड्रग विच वर इंट्रोड्यूस इन द ईयर 1960 एंड आफ्टर देयर इंट्रोडक्शन दे हैव रिप्लेस्ड द ड्रग बारबिट्यूरेट्स। व्हाई दे हैव रिप्लेस्ड द ड्रग? बिकॉज दे हैव हाई थेरापेटिक इंडेक्स and they do not affect the respiratory system and CVS functions. And also flumazenil is a drug which act as antagonist for benzodiazepines and used in the benzodiazepine toxicity. If we talk about a structure, then this is the general structure of benzodiazepine, having three rings, that is ring A, ring B and ring C. The ring A is an aromatic ring, the ring B is a 7-membered unsaturated ring, and the ring C is also an aromatic ring. Now the term benzodiazepines has been given for this structure? Because it have ring A, which is an aromatic ring, which is a benzene ring, hence the term benzo is used. Now the ring B is a 7-membered unsaturated ring and having two nitrogens. The first nitrogen is present at first position and the second nitrogen is present at fourth position. And because of both of these two nitrogens, it is diazo. If we go through the heterocyclic nomenclature, then azo is used for two nitrogens. Azo is used for nitrogens and di is two nitrogens. And it is a 7-membered unsaturated ring, so it is epine. So if we add on all the three terms, then the term benzodiazepines is given to this structure. So what is the purpose of this ring C? This ring C provides planarity to the structure and helps in binding to the receptor. Now modification in this general structure can result to various drugs of this categories, and various drugs of this categories are classified into these forms. What is the classification? The ultra short acting drugs, the short acting drugs, the medium acting drugs and the long acting drugs. What are the examples which comes under ultra short acting? If we talk about ultra short acting, the examples are triazolam and midazolam. If we talk about short acting drugs of this category, the drugs are example lorazepam and timazepam. The next category is medium acting, and the drugs are nitrazepam and alprazolam. The next category is long acting drugs, for example diazepam and chlordiazepoxide. All these structures of the drugs were generated from this general structure by substituting different groups. And if we talk about ultra short acting, short acting, medium acting, then all of these categories of drugs are used in the treatment of insomnia as sedative and hypnotics. But if we talk about long acting, the drugs like diazepam and chlordiazepoxide is used in the treatment of used as anxiolytics. So what are the different uses of benzodiazepines? Benzodiazepines are used as sedative and hypnotics in the treatment of insomnia. They are used as anxiolytics, they are used as anticonvulsants, they are used as muscle relaxants, used in alcohol withdrawal, and also used for pre-medications in different medical and dental cases. Now coming to the mechanism of actions of benzodiazepine. Benzodiazepine have a GABA facilitatory action, and through this action it can increase the opening time of chloride ion channels, and increase in timing of chloride ion channels can lead to the greater influx of the chloride ion, which results in hyperpolarization and hence muscle relaxation. How this occur? This occur because of binding of benzodiazepines to GABA A receptor. This is the figure for GABA A receptor, that is GABA A receptor chloride ion channel macromolecule complex. This is a ligand gated ion channel. And if we talk about structure, then it is made up of five sub units. So it is also known as pentameric structure. It is also known as pentameric structure. And this pentameric structure is made up of 2 alpha subunit, 2 beta subunit, and 1 gamma subunit. And for these subunits, there are 2 binding sites for GABA. GABA is gamma aminobutyric acid, and this is an inhibitory neurotransmitter. Why there is 2 binding sites for GABA? Because there are 2 alpha and 2 beta subunits, and binding site for GABA is present between alpha and beta. So there are 2 binding sites for GABA. And if we talk about agonist and antagonist for GABA, then mucimol is the drug which act as agonist for GABA, and bicoline is the antagonist for GABA. So this is the structure of GABA A receptor, at which different drugs, either they are GABA facilitatory or they are GABA mimic drugs, or they are non-benzodiazepine drugs, or they are benzodiazepine antagonist, can bind to GABA A receptor at different sites to give their action. The final action is the opening of chloride channels, which results in hyperpolarization. One by one we can discuss all. That is, coming to the benzodiazepine binding site, this is the benzodiazepine binding site which is present between alpha and gamma subunit. This is point to be noted, that benzodiazepine site is present, binding site is present between alpha and gamma subunit. When benzodiazepine drugs bind to these sites, then there is conformational change in this receptor, and this conformational change can result in modulation of GABA action. What happens when benzodiazepine bind to its site? Then both of the alpha subunits stretch away, which can form a pore between the receptor, and this pore will result in influx of chloride ions in the receptor. And influx of chloride ion in the receptor can result in muscle relaxation and CNS depressant activity. Now, flumazenil is the antagonist for the benzodiazepines. This is the binding site for the flumazenil, which is just below the benzodiazepine. Flumazenil is the antagonist drug which is used in the poisoning of the benzodiazepine. Means, if the chloride ion opening time is very high and the chloride influx is very high, then the muscle relaxation is very high, then what happens? Flumazenil is given, which is act as antagonist. They can decrease the size of pore, by which the chloride influx decreases, and hence can antagonize the effect of benzodiazepine. One more drug I have shown here is Zolpidem. Zolpidem is a non-benzodiazepine drug. It can also bind between alpha and gamma subunit just before flumazenil, and the mechanism of action for Zolpidem is same as benzodiazepine. Means it can also increase the time duration of chloride ion channel, results in hyperpolarization and muscle relaxation. If we talk about barbiturates, then the binding site of barbiturates present between alpha and beta subunits, and there are 2 alpha and beta subunits, so there are 2 binding sites for barbiturates also, and barbiturates can also results in increase in chloride ion channel opening, which results in hyperpolarization and muscle relaxation. But what is the difference between barbiturates and benzodiazepines? This is the important point. Benzodiazepine at higher doses may act as may give GABA mimic action. Means at this point they don't require GABA anymore. They can give itself give the longer duration to chloride ion channels, which can affect the respiratory system and CVS functions. But if we talk about benzodiazepines, they don't have any GABA mimic action, so they have greater therapeutic index, and they are more safer drug for us. So this is the mechanism of action of benzodiazepines.